Yeah.
What's happening?
People might have to
move
their cars.
No, they'll hit. But I'm going to be following you.
Thank you.
I'll be following you, okay? No,
okay.
Okay, thank you. Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, do you want me to enter? Okay. I could turn here a little bit, see, yeah. Yeah. Good. Okay.
Up to me, man.
Okay. Is that alright?
Yeah, come on, come on. Yeah, you're good.
Yeah, I'll leave it just around here. Let's talk about it.
You want to leave your key with me in case of emergency they want to move it?
Yeah.
My name is Alex.
Okay, Alex.
Don't skin me.
Okay. Yeah.
How do you do that, bro?
So you're not allowed to walk around during the service. Would you all please stand? Is his faithfulness. Let us pray. God of all consolation, your son Jesus Christ was moved to tears at the grave of Lazarus, his friend. Look with compassion on your children in their loss. Give to troubled hearts the light of hope and strengthen in us the gift of faith in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And as children of our loving Heavenly Father, let us ask his forgiveness, for he is gentle and full of compassion. When I say, Lord, have mercy, I'd like to repeat those words after me. God of mercy, we acknowledge that we are sinners and we turn from the wrong that we do and said and done, and are mindful of all that we have failed to do. For the sake of Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and help us to live each day in the light of Christ our Lord. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may God our Father, forgive us our sins and bring us to the eternal joy of his kingdom, where dust and ashes have no dominion. A merciful Father, hear our prayers and comfort us. Renew our trust in your Son, whom you raised from the dead. Strengthen our faith that all who have died in the love of Christ will share in his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forevermore. Amen. If you'd like to be seated, everybody, thank you very much. So, just to let you know that we are following this all service, but we're also following the Church of England all service, so it's like a bit of a mixture of the two. But the actual order is in the little booklet that you've got, and all your hymns are in the booklet as well. And when those who are reading or doing little tributes do your part, if you'd like to come and stand here where I'm standing now, and you'll be fine. The microphone works fine. Thank you. So I think we've got the biography in the booklet, so I'm not going to read it out. It's on page 1. You can read that for yourselves, and I know that Rob's brother as well will be reading a biography as well in the service, so you'll be able to follow that. And so we're now just going to invite Emma to do her little tribute. And if I could ask you all to keep your tributes nice and short, that would be great. Thank you.
John Fanshaw, who I affectionately called Darling, was a wonderful husband, father, grandfather, uncle, and father to many. I thank God for the opportunity to be his wife for 22 years and 5 months, and I look back over these years with so much happiness. I'm grateful for every moment we had together. The last few moments have been the darkest and saddest moments of my life. I'm not sure I can really express just how much I will miss him. I'm going to be so lost without him. He took personal interest in all our 3 children, namely Leighton, Josephine, and Bradford, particularly their education. He assured that we were financially independent by setting up businesses, providing roofs over our heads, food on the table, and clothes on our backs. We never lacked anything. He set an example as a husband and father. He was a simple, hardworking, honest, and compassionate person. He was very well-mannered and polite. He had the ability to make everyone feel comfortable and secure. Wherever Bob went, he brought a smile, shared a warm hug, or a firm handshake, followed by words of encouragement. Many will continue to remember his heart of love, generosity, and selfless attitude which he extended to many. He was my steadfast rock, who helped me through thick and thin. When I was upset, he stayed calm. When I was discouraged, he would encourage me. As in every marriage, we had our ups and downs, but through God's mercy and faithfulness, he kept us together for his glory. Bob, you are so many things to so many people, always giving out to others in various ways, financially, kind and encouraging. You were like a father to me. The sugar, water, honey and salt. I always remain grateful and comforted, knowing how much you positively affected the lives of so many people. And I thank the Almighty God for giving you a beautiful passage in my arms. No amount of words I write can ever say or describe how much I will miss you daily. Your children, the rest of your family, your many benefactors and I are grateful to you. I will never forget how kind and generous you are to us all. You will forever be in my heart. Good memories of you I'm holding on to. Bob, Dad, rest well.
Thank you very much, and thank you, Emma, and thank you for reading so lovely for us as well. And so we're now going to say Psalm 23, which you'll find on page 6 in your Ordinary Service booklet. We can't sing it because we're all wrong version, but we'll say it, and our audience will play music as we say. So shall we stand
and we'll slowly say Psalm 23 together. The Lord is my shepherd, I lack nothing. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He lays me beside quiet waters. He refreshes my soul. He guides me all along the right path for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely your goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Shall we sit for our first reading from the Bible, from Romans chapter 8?
What then shall we say in response to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own son, but gave him up for us all, how will he not also, along with him, graciously give us all things? Who will bring any charge against those whom God has chosen? It is God who justifies. Who then is the one who condemns? No one. Christ Jesus, who died, more than that, who was raised to life, is at the right hand of God, and is also interceding for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall trouble or hardship or persecution or famine or nakedness or danger or sword? As it is written, for your sake we face death all day long. We are considered as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth nor anything else is in all creation, will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Thank you very much. So we're now going to sing our first hymn, Amazing Grace, which is on page 8 in the order of service. Shall we stand? Gospel reading from the Gospel according to St. John.
Jesus comforts his disciples. Do not let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. My Father's house has many rooms. If that were not so, would I have told you that I'm going there to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to be with me, that you also may be where I am. You know the way, the place where I am going. Jesus, the way to the Father. Thomas said to him, Lord, we don't know where you are going, so how can we know the way? Jesus answered, I am the way, and the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me.
Now speak in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you. Seated, everybody. Thank you very much. As I was saying before, it's lovely to see so many of you here today, family and friends and representatives from the City of London, and also the Royal Marines, Bugler and Ambler of the City of London, Baron as well, and the Bishop from the church across the road, and John Barney, from former member of the Greenwich Council, our former councillor. Lovely to see you all, and many others as well. Thank you for coming, everyone. And so we are here today, firstly, to give thanks for the remarkable and wonderful life of Robert John Fanshaw, or Bob, as many of you knew him. And we're here today to remember him, to give thanks for his life, and there's so much in his life that we all want to give thanks for. Wasn't it an incredible life? And we really do want to give thanks today. And also, I know that members of the family are going to be giving your eulogies in just a few minutes as well. And so we look forward to listening to those. And I don't want to repeat what you're going to say, so I'm going to keep what I'm saying fairly short and just give a little biblical exhortation in just a moment. But suffice to say that Robert was and will be much loved and remembered always by his wife and his children and his brother and sister, by Leighton and Bradford, by Josephine and Christina and Charlie, and of course his wife Emma as well, and by the rest of the family and by the community as well. And the fact that so many of us here today shows how much he was respected and loved in our community as well. And also, of course, you'd be remembered by and much loved by the rest of the family, especially as a grandfather and as a father, a husband, earlier on to Antonia, and of course for many years now to Emma as well, and also as a much loved brother to his brother and sister as well. So, just a couple of short biblical exhortations on the readings that we had today. We heard from Romans chapter 8, which reminds us that we are all more than conquerors through Jesus Christ who loved us. And I remember many years ago sitting in a church in Northern Ireland during the Troubles. And it was a Protestant church, and the preacher was, preaching and the way that they do in Northern Ireland. And he talked about us all being more than conquerors. And it always stuck in my mind that what he said, that we are in Jesus Christ more than conquerors, and through Jesus Christ who loves us. And as a soldier, Robert knew what it meant to fight and also to conquer as well. And it must have also been aware that the way that we can conquer in this life, even in wars and troubled times is limited, but Jesus is the great conqueror, the one who can truly conquer over life and even over death itself. And that's why in Jesus Christ, we're more than conquerors. We're more than conquerors in Jesus Christ. And our second reading today came from John chapter 14, that reminds us that ultimately what matters in life is that God is our Heavenly Father, and that God loves us all as His children. And you remember the prayer that we always say, and we're going to be saying it today in our service, our Father who art in heaven. It reminds that God is our Heavenly Father, our Father who art in heaven. And God loves us all, each and every one of us, whether we remember Him all the time or not. God still loves us and cares about us, just as His children, because we are God's sons and daughters, each and every one of us, and God's children. And Robert, Bob, was one of God's much loved children as well. And as God's children, we're all welcome into God's heavenly home, as the reading reminds us. In my house, there are many mansions, it says in John's Gospel. In other words, in God's house, in heaven, there is much room for us all. Just like any parents who love their children, and God loves us all as His children, there's much room for us all in God's heavenly home. And that's where we're today committing Robert too, into God's heavenly home. And so it is today sad to be letting go of Robert in this life, especially for you, his family and friends. And that is hard. But at the same time, it's with joy that we are here to commit him into God's presence, God, our Heavenly Father's presence, today. Amen. So I think, Peter, you're going to give us a little biography, and then your sister, Mary, is going to read a poem for us as well. Thank you.
Robert John was born 15th of June 1948, our brother, and we all lived on a farm at the edge of the Cotswolds. At a young age, he started to be very affectionately known as Bob, and also a great reader of books, and also enjoyed riding horses throughout his life. Mary and Bob would often go to the neighbouring farm to help break in young horses, Anne, Judith, Susan and Caroline. Primary school for him was a prep school in Banbury called St. Louis. In summer holidays, Bob would often be seen camping down the fields with Jonathan Gibbs or with his cousin James. Cowmen on the farm always joked about the camping exploits and the buzzing around, flies buzzing around the pots and pans. In 1960, he won a scholarship to a public school in Herefordshire called Belmont, during which time his achievements were completing bronze, silver and gold Duke of Edinburgh Award. He had become head boy Duke of Edinburgh Award. He had become head boy in prep and public schools. During the summer of 1966, after leaving school, and whilst waiting to join the Wandering Commandos, he enjoyed a visit with Dad to the elderly spinster aunts who lived in Reading. Bob always wanted to be at the top, so he joined the Royal Marines as a young officer. And during his training at Limpston, he was able to participate in parachute jumping. In those days, the parachutes he would use required a rollover landing. But on one occasion, Bob thought he would try a stand-up landing to see what would happen, and consequently broke his leg. When training was complete, there were two postings available, Middle East or snow warfare in Norway. Bob chose the latter. For many winters during the next 20 years, he spent in Norway. During that time, he met and married Nina, who commented that the best thing to come out of their marriage was Charlie and Christina. In 1988, he was posted to Australia with Nina for 2 years. Whilst Charlie and Christina were being educated in England, he meant they travelled to Australia at school holiday times. When Bob retired from the Royal Ring of Mines, he moved to London to work for a train company, and later on, in 2002, met and married Anna. They had three children, Len, Justine, and Brad. Bob and Anna and Brad pub together, and also purchased other properties, including one in Darwin. During that time, he became a writer and wrote a trilogy of books based on the First World War, and had them published. He also wrote plays. In latter years, Bob was experiencing eye troubles, which affected his ability for reading and writing. He was eventually diagnosed with ocular lymphoma, but his treatment was delayed due to COVID, and sadly, 2 days before his 75th birthday, he passed away. Mary would like to say a poem to remember.
To the living I am gone, to the sorrowful I will never return. To the angry I was cheated, but to the happy I am at peace, and to the faithful I have never left. I cannot be seen, but I can be heard. So as you stand upon a shore, gazing at a beautiful sea, remember me. As you look in awe at a mighty forest and its grand majesty, remember me. As you look upon a flower and admire its simplicity, remember me. Remember me in your heart, your thoughts, your memories of the times we loved, the times we cried, the times we laughed. For if you always think of me, I will never be gone. Robert was a much loved grandfather, father, husband and brother. Rest in peace, Robert.
Thank you very much, Peter and Mary. And in a moment, we're going to sing our second hymn, Lord of All Hopefulness, which you'll find on page 11 in your order of service. And we'll start to sing that in just a moment. And after the hymn, we have our other tributes, which I'm not going to announce them all. So after the hymn, if you just come up one after the other, those who are doing tributes, and that would be great. Our last tribute will be by Leighton, who'll say a few words as well. So I won't announce them, just come up after the hymn. So shall we all stand to sing Lord of All Hopefulness?
Thank you.
Throughout my dad's battle with cancer and seeing him slowly deteriorate, I couldn't help but feel upset and nostalgic about the times when he would drive me around, when he would take my brothers and I wherever we asked, whether it be to a theme park, to go swimming, or to go to the cinema. I would especially remember the significant stuff we shared together when we would go and watch the ballet or opera together. I find enjoyment in these moments we had, whether it be bursts of laughter we shared in the living room, or the embrace of your hugs. Unfortunately, I had to get used to this new norm, which was hard. I would go and see my dad during his time in the hospital after school, and the weekends I spent with him and my mum at the house, not knowing that he would be taken from us so soon. Dad, I know that you was fighting as hard as you could, and that you held on for as long as you could. I can't imagine how hard it was for you, and how much you were suffering, but you can now finally be at peace and be at rest. And just know that you did so much. Not only did you greatly impact me, but various people that you encountered throughout your life. People got to see just how much of a kind, patient, light-hearted, adventurous, funny and thoughtful person you were. You were a great dad, and those traits will live on in me and my brothers. I'm so grateful to have had a wonderful father like you. You did everything for me, even if it was at the expense of doing something for yourself. You spoiled me, you always praised me, even when I didn't deserve it, and I can never repay you back for that. But I can promise that I will make you proud of me. I love you so much, Dad, please don't forget that. I never doubt this. You no longer have to worry or to suffer, you can just rest. And you can look over my mom, my brothers, my family, and everyone. I miss you, thank you for everything you did, and that I will never forget you, from your princess.
Hello. Yeah, this tune is from Judith Family. This is Amen Family, and they can also back on Ghana. It is with deepest soul and sadness that you write this tune. But you are all blessed for having known you, for having loved you and being loved by you. To have called you our own, you were a father, an uncle, a brother, and a friend to us. And you were so fun to be around. You touched so many lives by your selfless and tactless act of kindness, always giving and never expecting any favor in return. Your dedication to a cause was set you apart. You were so humble, kind, loving, caring, and in a good in your heart and soul. You were always around us. We remember that yesterday, how you never failed to check on us, support, wives, and check Joseph us. We never see Bob's side or come with him. He's a lovely person to live around. But we are going to miss him. You're such a wonderful man, and we will always be grateful to you. But you have done a lot for us, even including me. And I will never forget you. You're always in my heart, and your spirit will always be fed wherever you are. Bob, let me thank you. Well, farewell. We can still remember vividly the joyful expression you always exhibited whenever you met during Christmas dinner in your house. Even when you visit Ghana at family event, the cheerful in you and the ongoing generosity, that was your unique identity. We will really miss you and your honest fatherly advice. Your sudden departure came as a shock, as a good shock. Whilst we are mourning today, we also take comfort in the fact that your mission on this earth has been fulfilled. Bob never lived by himself alone. He lived for many, especially who would be in the power. Even when some people come, they don't have money to buy a drink or food. Bob would take public, serve them. If they got money, they should come and pay. And a lot of them do not even come back. And sometimes Bob will be sleeping around 3 o'clock a.m. Someone will knock the door. Bob, I don't have money to go. And Bob will call a cab for the person. And sometimes some people come to the bar. They are drinking. They don't know where they are going. Frustration. Bob will comfort them, have time with them. Like, Pope never discriminate. Pope don't care about your color. And Pope respect people so much, like he respect everybody's decision, whatever you want. I remember Pope brought me to this country when I was invested for holidays in Piedmont, other trips, like he did a lot for me after school. I asked Pope, I can't find a job. Can I come back and leave? When I came up, asked me, Kwame, you want to work with me or you want to work with someone? I said, oh, Bob, I'll work with you. And I don't know how to describe Bob. And I was being with Bob, and I remember when I started making family, I told Bob, it's too hard for me. I need a different place because the family is too close and sometimes, you know, Africa, oh, this, oh, we should do this. So Bob, I want to move a little bit away from, to have a little bit peace of mind. And I told Bob, and Bob respect everybody's decision, whatever you are. Bob is so wonderful man. I don't know how to describe Bob as a person, like in terms of personality. I've never met someone like Bob before in my life. Bob, you're such a wonderful man. Everybody remember you too. As you mourn today, you also take comfort in the fact that your mission on earth has been fulfilled. Because I always say, Bob is a legend, and your legacy always living, Bob. We thank God, we thank the Lord for your life, and wish you have more time to continue to appreciate you. God, in His indefinite wisdom, knows best, and we know and believe that God will not take you away from us, rather, just made you an angel with big wings to fly to look after all your loved ones from up in the sky. May the good Lord comfort and sustain all of us here. May the good Lord keep you safe, grant you a very peaceful place, Bob, for you to rest until all meet again. Bob, Dwumfour, Bob, farewell.
Was a brilliant actor, playing two roles in All About the Boys.
Fridolin's father and the brigadier. But in every role he performed over the years, he was a consummate professional, always bringing each character to life. As well as plays, Bob wrote poetry, prose, and his World War trilogy about the cellist friend. He was a regular contributor to the GFMA monthly poetry, spoken word, and music night, and was the featured writer in 2022 when he published the last book in the World War trilogy, Rest Not Please Dead. Everything he wrote was rich, deep, full of insight, and so well researched. He was a master of his craft. Bob was strong, generous, creative, erudite, and funny. He had a great sense of humor. He was a wonderful man and a true friend. One of the lines from his play, All About the Boys, when Bob, playing the brigadier, said, "One final push, that's all I ask," is a line that I quote often when things get tough for GFMA, and I always remember Bob. And his strength of purpose. He touched so many people in his life, and we at GFMA will miss him so much. And we are eternally grateful to have known him. Our thoughts go out to his family, and we thank them for sharing this truly inspirational man with us.
Unfortunately, I don't think Robert could make it today. For those that don't know, I'm Charles. I'm Robert and Antonina's first son. Thank you all for coming here today. It is greatly appreciated. And for those that haven't mentioned that, I'm truly honoured, and I know that Dad would have been amazed to see so many people hear so many tremendous words about him. He would have felt joy and pride in the outpouring of love and support for the families today and all the people here present. I know we've heard many wonderful things about Dad's life and the events that molded him, affected him, and turned him into the person so many of us came to know and love. I wanted to touch on a few things of those that molded me by the man and dad that he was. I was rereading recently one of Dad's first books, The Cellist Friend, and it still makes me incredibly proud to say that, as I know how much of his life he strived to achieve that goal, not only to be a writer, a poet, a playwright, but to be an author and to hold one his own book in his hands, to pass on one of the purest forms of art, invention, and imagination through the medium of words, his words, to pass his words on to others and the hope that they can give inspiration or enjoyment for the message or story he was trying to convey. I am so pleased he got to achieve this goal in his lifetime. Yet sadly, he couldn't go on to work at all as he often talked to the fans with his other works. Rereading his book, I became aware of the amount of human connection that his book retold, both in tragedy and through conflicts of war or trauma, but also in shared connections of human life, chance or planned meetings of strangers, family and friends, I reflect on the dad, on the life dad has so unfortunately left behind that he built with Amma, Leighton, Josephine and Bradford, and providing a hub for community and connection in running the Castle Tavern, a space for others to meet, gather and be friends. I believe that this is closely related to his recent writing, and Leighton has mentioned to me so many times that dad was so highly respected in this community and for making time to talk to people and form connections. As for my older memories of Dad, I remember the smell of his uniform and trying on his Royal Marine Commando beret when I was young, carrying his kit around the house, going to the stores at camp and stealing chocolate from the ration packs. Always a particular highlight if others hadn't got there before us. I was proud of my dad for being a soldier, but in reality I probably didn't understand the level of commitment and strife it puts on a person and family. Serving in the Troubles in Northern Ireland, and then two wars. However, he really did enjoy some of his time in the service, especially his times in Norway. Dad was away a lot though, and we missed him. Mum and Dad would always take us out walking on the moors, both in Scotland and in the moors of Devon and Dartmoor. I remember when Christina was young, she was carried in one of his big military rucksacks as she couldn't manage the walk, and probably fell asleep and curled up at the bottom. Both Mum and Dad encouraged our exploring of the outdoors, and it was something I would forever be grateful for, as I continue to enjoy getting out with my family and perhaps with you by the river after jumping in the swim. I will miss my dad for more reasons than you will ever know. I had been hoping to take him back to the mountains in Scotland for an adventure to retrace some of those picnics that Mum used to take us on around Braemar and Glensheen whilst he was away training in Norway. However, unfortunately, that opportunity was taken away from me as Dad's tragic illness took hold of him. I would miss talking to him about football, rugby, and the nuances of cricket commentators. Although, unfortunately, Geoffrey Boycott is no longer on the airwaves, as we both used to roll our eyes at his lengthy criticism of a not-so-well-played forward cover drive or something. I will miss him randomly quoting Shakespeare or other famous playwrights, more often than not purely because it amused him. Most of all, I, and I'm sure so will Christina, Leighton, Josephine, and Bradford, will miss just not being able to talk to their dad. No one can really replace a dad, although I'm sure that Amma, Antonina, and all the family members here today will go on to offer comfort, love, and support when needed. There's so many people here that have offered such kind words through all their tributes. I'm really touched and proud of my dad. Not to replace the love and affection of our dad, but to help, remember and cherish those moments we did get with him. I know that on days such as today, exam results day, Dad is and forever will be incredibly proud of Bradford, Josephine and of course Leighton for all their achievements and those yet to come. I know that as I climb a tour on the depths of Dartmoor or watch a match on the telly, I know that Dad is there with me. And I hope that you too can hold him in your hearts, minds, and talk to him when you choose to do so. Rest in peace, Dad. I love you.
Hello, everyone. I'm Bradford. They will never really prepared anything, but I just wanted to talk about my dad real quick. My dad was actually the best, like literally the best. I can't even put into words how much I love him. I can recall so many moments of him doing good acts. I remember all the time before school, he'd pick up all my friends and wave them together, and he'd take us straight to school and bring us straight back. All my birthdays, he would take me, no matter what I asked. He always paid. He did everything he could for everyone, and he made sure everyone was happy. No matter what you do, like if you look around, you see different people. My dad loved everyone. He was truly the best and the sweetest man. And I always regret not speaking to him as much as I could, because I always thought, when you're sick, I was thinking, when I finish with school, when I finish my GCSEs, I'll be able to go and speak to him. But that never happened. My dad died on my last GCSE. I had to go and see him straight after my exam. It was the saddest moment of my life, not gonna lie to you. I miss my dad every day. I remember one time for my 20th birthday, he bought me shoes. They were the ugliest pair of shoes, but I didn't want to be rude. And he told me, one day we're going to take this, we're going to go on a hike. And I said, yeah, we're going on a hike. But then he got got cancelled. We never got to go on a hike. And I just feel bad that I never got to actually speak to him, never got to talk to him as much as I should have. I never hugged him as much as I should have. I'll see him again, but I never got to see him again. I never got to speak to him again. I always miss my dad, I always remember him. He was literally the sweetest man. I can even remember another time. There was someone passed out right in front of the pub. I was asleep, my dad came, took the pillow, gave it to the man, not my favorite pillow, but I was even showing him at the time. But now when I think about it, my dad is just, he's just the sweetest man. I'm so proud and I'm so grateful that I can call him my dad, and I'll make sure that his name will never go down, his name will never die. My dad will always be in my heart. I love you, Dad. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. I would like to personally say thank you to Jesse, Dax, the funeral directors, all the church staff. This has been a very hard couple of months. Where do I start? I'm going to keep it quite short because my dad was the best. Me and him had a very special relationship. He was always there. He taught me a lot. He showed me the real value. He taught me how to be a real man. I could never thank him enough for everything he's done for me. I'm just going to say one thing and then that's it. I'll carry on his legacy and I'll keep on trying to make it greater because he inspired every single person here and he truly meant a lot to everyone here. And there's nothing I could do to be like him. I'll keep on trying to be as good as he was. Thank you.
Thank you very much for that. Dax is going to lead us in our prayers.
Let us pray. After each prayer, when I say, Lord, in your mercies, your response will be, hear our prayers. Lord, in your mercies,
hear our prayers.
This is a very sad work for me to do today because Bob was my very, very good friend. Let us pray again. We pray for our church universal. We pray for all our bishops and all of the bishops. Pray for the Pope. We pray for our own Archbishop of Canterbury. We pray for our own Bishop Christopher, Bishop of Southwark. We also pray for our area Bishop, Dr. Caraway Dogo, Bishop of Woolwich. We pray for their various ministries. And we hope that they'll continue to lead us as good shepherds in your vineyard. Lord, in your mercies.
Amen.
We pray for our rector, Jesse, who is conducting this service today. We pray for his family. We are grateful to have him in our midst. We thank him for all the good things he has done for this community. In the almost 30 years he's been in our midst. As he reaches out even further into the community, we ask for more wisdom in his pastoral work. Grant him circle, direct him, and continue to bless the work of his hands. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayers.
We pray for our community here in Woolwich. We thank you for bringing us together. We thank you that despite our many differences, you continue to make us friends of one another. This is a very, very international community. This is a very multicultural community has worked for us. We pray that you continue to look after us. Lord, in your mercies. Today, we are burying Bob. My friend Bob. How cruel can death be? This one has really stunk. Bob was a good husband to Abba, father to Charlie, to Christina, to Nathan, to Josephine, and to Bradford. A good husband, a good father, a good sibling to Mary and to Peter, a good friend, a brilliant employee, an outstanding community champion, one of life's genuine good guys. At 75, it's far too young to die. But only you know why you have taken him at this time. We thank you for the life he has lived, a fulfilling life, a life of achievements, a life of helping others, a worthy life. As an author, a worthy life of supporting his children as he goes home to rest. We pray that by the mercy of God, and sitting with Saint Michael and all the angels, he will rest in peace and rise in glory. Lord, in your mercies. We pray for Amma. We pray for her children, our stepchildren, our relatives, both here in the UK and abroad. But as they continue with life without war, we look after them. We also pray for all their employees who are regarded as family, and some of whom are present in church today, that they will retain their loyalty to the establishment, even though the employer and mentor is gone. Lord, in your mercies. Finally, let us take one moment to pray for ourselves. We thank the cathedral across the road for the order of service. We thank Bishop Williams and his Chief of Staff, Charles. We thank all of Bob and Amma's friends from far and wide. We pray that all the upcoming festivities will go with your blessings in Jesus' name. We pray for our jobs. We pray for our businesses, our relationships, our challenges. We thank you that even as this cost of living debacle carries on, you continue to sustain us, to bless us, to provide for us. We know and believe that you will continue to look after us. Father, we thank you. We praise you. We call upon you. Hear our prayers. Please say after me, Merciful Father, accept these prayers. the sake of your Son,
our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Thank you very much, Dax. And shall we also just end our prayers with the Lord's Prayer, which we'll all say together in the traditional version. Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Well, now comes the commendation and farewell, where we commend Bob into God's heavenly house and say farewell to him in this earthly realm. And so we're going to stand, everyone. Thank you. Let us commend Robert John Fanshaw to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. We stand, remain standing. So we're going to, in a moment, sing our final hymn, which is Abide With Me. It's on the last page in your order of service, on page 26. After that, we will process out behind the coffin. And can I ask the people upstairs to be, when you go out, please go out the door that side. Not that side. If you go that side, you might fall through the steps. So please go out that side. Thank you very much. So shall we remain standing to sing Abide With Me?
Christ come for them.
Thank you, everybody.
Thank you very much, Paulo. Ladies and gentlemen, we are now going to make our way to the cemetery, so stay tuned. Thank you very much for tuning in and also showing your love to the family. Family is so grateful. God bless you all. Stay tuned.
Thank you. There's a photo of me in there, and then people just started laughing.
When you're ready anyway, we can go.
Okay, we're getting ready to move now, so we'll give us some few minutes to put ourselves together. Thank you very much.
Hello. So sorry, I need to come out. I'll be following the heads. Yeah, that's me.
Thank you.
Great goodness. As a father is tender towards his children, so is the Lord tender to those that fear him. For he knows of what we are made. He remembers that we are but dust. Our days are like the grass. We flourish like a flower of the field. When the wind goes over it, it is gone, and its place will know it no more. But the merciful goodness of the Lord endures forever and ever towards those that fear him, and his righteousness upon their children's children. We just have a reading from Psalm 121. I lift up my eyes to the hills. From where is my help to come? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. He will not suffer your foot to stumble. He who watches over you will not sleep. Behold, he who keeps watch over Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord himself watches over you. The Lord is your shade at your right hand, so that the sun shall not strike you by day, neither the moon by night. The Lord shall keep you from all evil. It is he who shall keep your soul. The Lord shall watch over you, your going out and your coming in, from this time forward and forevermore. Amen. We have entrusted our brother Robert to God's mercy,
and we now commit his body to the ground. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, in sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life, to our Lord Jesus Christ, who was transform our frail bodies, that we may be conformed to his glorious body, who died, was buried, and rose again. To him be glory forever. Amen. And we'll say together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Now, Lord, let your servant go in peace. Your word has been fulfilled. My own eyes have seen the salvation which you have prepared in the sight of every people. A light to reveal you to the nations and the glory of your people Israel. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now and shall be forever. Amen. Amen. Heavenly Father, in your Son Jesus Christ, you have given us a true faith and a sure hope. Strengthen this faith and hope in us all our days, that we may live as those who believe in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Support us, O Lord, all the day long of this troublous life, until the shadows lengthen and the evening comes and the busy world is hushed. The fever of life is over and our work is done. Then, Lord, in your mercy, grant us safe lodging, a holy rest, and peace at the last, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. May God give you his comfort and his peace, his light and his joy in this world and the next, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon Robert and upon all of you, now and forevermore. Amen. And unto him that is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, to the only wise God, our Saviour, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forevermore. Amen. Thank you. Thank you.
Sorry, can I take a picture of you? All together, yeah? Thank you. I'll take a picture of the three of you, please. Yeah? Liam. Okay.
asked.
Don't ask yourself. Well, he's asking when do you get the footage and photos?
Oh, I'm going to, with, by next week.
Are you going to be on Saturday here as well?
Yeah.
Okay, good.
Okay.
So we're cousins, I think.
Oh, yeah.
So sorry if you're not. Right, right. So first up with me.
I'm at the cemetery.
Thank you.
Thank you.
We missed it.
Oh, but it hasn't been covered, so
we were in the other place.
Sorry. Yeah. That's happened to me before. Yeah. Then we are all settled. I'll come back. I'll do a part 2.